Tesla's having a great year. This month, the electric vehicle maker became the first car maker to hit a $1 trillion valuation. But 15 years ago, it wasn't certain that the company would be where it is today. And the CEO who introduced the company's first Roadster in 2006 wouldn't become the face of the company or a billionaire.
Tesla's early days, from its founding in 2003 until about 2006, were an exciting and very volatile time for the company. Its two original founders, Martin Eberhard and Mark Tarpening, had come together with this idea to create an electric sports car because there really was nothing like that on the market at the time.
But around 2004, J.B. Straubel and Elon Musk arrived at Tesla.
They had some funding, but not nearly enough to start something as elaborate and cost and cash intensive as a new auto company. So in 2004, Eberhard and Tarpening came across Elon Musk, who had recently made a considerable amount of money from the sale of his stake in PayPal. Musk loved the idea for an electric vehicle and agreed to be their principal initial funder, putting the first major investment into the company in 2004.
Musk and Straubel developed a friendship and a common vision about what they wanted to do in the electric vehicle space. And over time, both of them became much more influential in the direction Tesla was taking. Although Eberhard and Tarpening came up with the original idea and brought on a third engineer, Ian Wright, those three men did not end up becoming billionaires as a result of Tesla's surge in shares over the past year. In large part, that's because Eberhard and Tarpening's original stakes were diluted significantly.
Over the years, each time the company arranged an additional funding round to raise more capital because making cars is very expensive, with each of those new funding rounds, it further diluted the holdings that Eberhard and Tarpening had because they were not at the same time investing their own money to maintain their existing stakes. In fact, there were a series of 9 funding rounds for Tesla between 2004 up until its IPO in 2010.
Ian Wright left the company in 2004, even before the public debut of the Roadster electric sports car. Wright has said he did not hold on to any of his Tesla shares, saying he could never imagine the company would end up being worth $1 trillion. And by 2007, Eberhard was forced out as CEO. Tarpening left a few months later. At the time, both men each held less than 5% in Tesla shares. Straubel, who left Tesla in 2019, is likely to have attained billionaire status from his holdings. His stake may be worth about $1.3 billion, assuming he retains a significant portion of Tesla stock that he held when he left. Straubel declined to comment for this story.
There were a series of other CEOs that were tapped to replace Eberhard, none of whom lasted very long, until Musk himself took control of the company a year later in 2008. Elon Musk was fairly strategic all along. His early money in Tesla brought the company to life. And through each subsequent funding round, he continued to invest more in the company, maintaining the largest stake of any individual investor. The company on November 1st crossed the $1 trillion valuation mark, and no one was a bigger beneficiary of that than Elon Musk. He currently owns approximately 20% of the company, and his stake in Tesla, as well as his investments in SpaceX and his other companies, have increased his net worth to an estimated $300 billion, making him the wealthiest person on the planet. So that early bet that he made on Tesla ultimately paid off far better than he or anyone else could have ever imagined.